Welcome back to another very exciting tutorial here at the PhotoshopTrainingChannel.com. My name is Jesus Ramirez, and you can find me on Instagram at JRFromPTC. In this video, I'll show you how you can use Photoshop's crop and straighten command to quickly and easily crop multiple scanned images into their own individual files. I'll also take the time to show you how to fix some of the most common issues that arise when scanning images into Photoshop. Okay, let's get started. We're going to work with this file, which contains 3 scanned photographs, and to quickly and easily crop them, straighten them, and place them in their own individual files, we're going to use Photoshop automation tools. I'm going to go into File, Automate, Crop and Straighten Photos. Photoshop will then crop and straighten the photos in that image. We have the 3 tabs here, 1, 2, and 3. As you can see, this was a quick and easy thing to do. Now, when you're looking at the photos, you may want to choose a different view. For example, you may want to arrange the tabs 4 up so you can see them all at the same time. Or maybe you just want to have floating windows and you can arrange them accordingly. Now, this is all personal preference, of course. I'm going to go back into Window, Arrange, Consolidate all to tabs. I like working with tabs better, but you may have a different preference. So now that we have the photos, we can adjust them accordingly. For example, you may notice that this photo here has some of the white outlines there. That's very easy to remove. You can do several things. You can click on the crop tool, hold shift, click and drag one of the corner handles, and then press enter. And that's going to crop that area out. Another thing that you can do is use the spot healing brush tool and use the right bracket key on the keyboard to make the brush bigger and then paint on those edges using content aware, and Photoshop will fill in those areas. If you're working with a photo and maybe that photo has a missing piece, so let me just fake that. I'm gonna make a selection and fill it with white. Control D, Command D to deselect. So now this photo has a piece missing. You can actually use the fill content aware command to generate the pixels. So I'm gonna click and drag and make a selection around that. Then I'm gonna go into Edit, Fill, Contents, choose Content Aware, press OK. Photoshop is gonna fill that in. You may not get it right the first time. If you don't, just make another selection with the pixels that don't look right to you, and then do it again, Edit, Fill, Content Aware. And if you think you need to do it one more time, then go ahead and do that a third time. This time I'm going to hold Shift and Backspace to bring up the Fill menu, and then press OK. Control D, Command D to deselect, and that looks much better. Another thing that you may come across is some of the old Polaroid photos, and you can decide to keep the white outline, or you can crop that in. And it's very easy to crop. Just select the Crop tool and match the edges yourself, and then press enter. I'm gonna zoom in just so we can see this image a little bit better. I'm holding Alt and scrolling up on the mouse wheel. And since this video is all about using the automation tools to crop and straighten, we'll also use the auto tools to adjust color, contrast, and tone. You can, of course, adjust the colors by going into Image and using one of the 3 auto commands here. So in this particular image, one of the things you may want to do is adjust the color. So click on Auto Color. You can also press Shift, Control B, Shift, Command B on the Mac. Auto Color. And that adjusts the colors of the image. If you're unhappy with the results, you can go into Edit, Fade, Auto Color, or press Shift, Control F, Shift, Command F on the Mac. And in the Fade command window, you can bring down the opacity of that effect, or you can also use a different blend mode. In this case, I like the colors, but maybe the image is a little bit too dark. So I'm gonna use a different blend mode to keep the colors, but bring back the old luminance values. So I'm gonna go into Mode and select Color. So that keeps the new colors, but brings up the old luminance values. Then I'm gonna press OK. Now that I'm looking at the image, this may be a little bit too bright. So I'm gonna go into Image, Auto Contrast. Again, the image is darker than I would like it to be, so I'm just gonna go into Edit, Fade Auto Contrast, and bring the opacity down a little bit, right about there, and then press OK. Now, you may come across an image that has a different problem. This image is showing portrait style, but it needs to be landscape. To fix that, we can just go into Image, image rotation, 90 degrees clockwise, and then rotate the image. You can see some of the white here, so we can fix that by just cropping it a little bit, just a tiny bit, and then the white edges are gone. You can, of course, apply any of the auto color commands if you want to, but I'm not going to do that in this case. We're going to come back into the image that we started with, and we're going to talk about one other issue that you may come up with when scanning images, and that is noise. Notice how this image has a lot of noise. There's not too much that you can do in a lot of cases, but you can certainly improve it. So I'm going to zoom in just so we can see what kind of noise we're dealing with, and notice that this noise has some color in there. And we're gonna use some of the Photoshop filters to try to make it just a little bit better. But before I do that, I'm just gonna go into Auto Color and Auto Tone. So this is what our image looks like now. I'm gonna zoom in, and obviously the noise is still there. So what I'm gonna do first is go into Filter, Noise, Reduce Noise. And this filter is gonna help us reduce some of that noise. So the first thing I'm gonna do is just bring down the sliders here to the left so you can see what the image looks like with nothing applied to it. So there it is. And obviously I have the preview checkbox enabled. And I'm just going to start out by increasing the strength all the way up just to see what it looks like. And in this particular case, dragging the strength up to 10 doesn't seem to damage the image in terms of losing detail and detail areas, simply because we really can't see, for example, her lips, her eyes are really not there. Even at zero, you really can't see them. So we're okay going all the way up to try to reduce some noise. So I'm gonna click on the checkbox and you see how that removes a little bit of noise. Then you can also reduce the color noise. Notice how we have some color noise here. Watch what happens when I drag this slider over to the right. I'm just gonna drag it all the way to the right again, just so you can see the difference. Look at the brown here. If I disable the preview checkbox, you can see that that noise has some color. If I enable it, that color is gone. So I do want to remove the color noise from this image. Again, in this case, using the strength of 10 and 100% here works. In your image, you may need to bring the strength down a little bit and also bring the color noise back a bit. It all depends on your image. In this particular case, I don't have a lot of detail to preserve. So actually preserving the detail brings back noise in areas that really don't require it. So I'm just gonna leave this at zero. So this looks good for now. I'm gonna press okay. At this point, this may be all that I can do, but I can try one other thing and see how it looks. I wanna go into Filter, Blur, Surface Blur. And this blur allows you to blur, but it leaves the edges intact. So notice here in the chair, how the edges are intact, the inside and the outside, in this case you really can't tell because it's a white highlight, are what's being blurred, not the edges. So again, you can just bring these down to zero. So to see the before and the after, you can start increasing the threshold, maybe 10 levels. And you can see before and after. So we're definitely getting rid of a lot of the noise that's here on the chair. It's not affecting her face too much. And then I can press okay. This looks good. I'm gonna zoom out. And that's what our image looks like. If I go into Window, History, I can come back right here, Auto Tone. So before and after. So certainly a lot less noise. Obviously, there's a whole lot of other problems and issues that may arise when scanning images into Photoshop, but these are some of the most common problems that you'll have and just a few ways in how to fix them. And that's it for this tutorial. I hope that you enjoyed it and that you learned something new. If you have any comments or questions, leave them down below. If you enjoy the tutorial, don't forget to click that like button and share this video with a friend. If you haven't already, subscribe to the Photoshop Training channel now. Thank you for watching, and I'll talk to you again soon.